Hi there and welcome to this RAMSS tutorial. To start off, go to my.ryerson.ca and click this RAMSS tab up top. If a pop-up window does not appear, it probably means that you're blocking your pop-up window, so make sure you check your settings. So to start off, we're going to go to our weekly schedule to see the classes that we've already been enrolled to. You may have been enrolled in classes because of course intentions or because they're mandatory, so let's take a look. And then once you're here, there are two ways to see your schedule, list view and the weekly schedule view. List view just shows you, quite literally, a list of the classes you've been enrolled to, and the weekly schedule view, which I personally prefer, gives you a more calendar-looking view of your schedule. One thing to be mindful of is that it may seem like you have no classes on Monday, but September 4th, which you see on the calendar, is actually a day that Ryerson isn't open, so if you click the Next Week button, you'll see, oh wait, I actually might have a class on Monday, so make sure you're checking that out before you assume you don't. So let's go to our shopping cart. We're going to click our term again, Fall 2017, and what you're going to see here in my shopping cart are classes that I want to enroll to. Think of it as an actual shopping cart. You haven't really checked out yet, but these are the classes that you want to take. Wonderful. And there's two ways to find classes to enroll into, class search and my classes offered. But before we do this, an important thing to do is go to your undergraduate calendar. So if you click here, you're going to see all the programs, choose yours. For the sake of this demonstration, we're going to do media production because that's my program. And then once you click here, you're going to see all of the courses that are required for you to graduate. So these might be mandatory classes, liberals you can take, open electives, and every program has a calendar like this. Seriously, print it out, put it on your fridge, this thing will save your life for the next few years that you are at Ryerson. As you can see, here's another example of this for industrial engineering. Let's go back to media production for a moment. Oh, wonderful, in first and second semester, I need a table A liberal. Click on that and you'll see all of these table A liberals, wonderful classes that you can take. And you know what, it's great. Look at all these classes, history, you got history of the Caribbean, Britain since 1815. You know what, I really wanna take a history class. It's a table A liberal, wonderful, let's go do it. Go back to RAMSS, remember it is a pop-up window. And we're gonna go to class search, and that code was HST. So remember, all the courses that are kind of in the same subject have a course code, HST for history. So you're gonna go to your subject and type it in, HST. Let's go see what classes are offered. Okay, great. So there's 19 different classes. Let's see what we got. Ooh, look at all these wonderful histories. Elizabethan England. Okay, you know what? That sounds great. I wanna take that. But then I look over here and wait a second, HST 532 is actually not a table A liberal, so make sure you're checking it out. But US History HST 110 sounds fun. Oh, great, it is a table A liberal. You know what, wonderful. I don't wanna wake up early, so let's choose the second one. And there we go, it's open, so there's space in the class. You press next, and it's added to your shopping cart. Woohoo! And as you can see, now it's there, and it's joined the list. Now, that takes a lot of time to go between class search and looking at the list, and what if it's not offered like Elizabethan England? So here is a tip and a trick. If you click My Classes Offered, you're gonna see this. It's a little bit overwhelming at first, but what this does is it breaks down all of your requirements. So for example, that would show all my required courses in first and second semester. I've taken them, I'm in fourth year, so it already says that I've done them, but let's take one that I haven't finished yet. So we scroll down, okay, three courses from table B. I know I haven't finished that yet. So what can I do? Press that green arrow. And if you go down and press view all, you're gonna see all the courses in table B, but here's the difference. These are the courses that are actually being offered. So unlike the list that you see to the left in the other browser, those are potential courses. These are the ones that are actually happening. So there's some that I've already done, so I'm obviously not gonna choose those. But let's say, okay, which one sounds cool? Okay, I like this one, espionage, let's click that one. Great, I'm gonna select it, I have all the information about it, wonderful, I'm gonna add it to my shopping cart. Okay, great. And there it is, it's in my shopping cart now. As you can see, it has joined the list. Now let's say I wanted to enroll, you know what, I'm gonna do this early, no big deal. First of all, you have to select at least one class, make sure you don't make that mistake. There's a little thing over there, those little boxes, make sure you're clicking them or else you're gonna be enrolling into nothing, so there you go. So you're gonna check off the classes, wonderful, or you're gonna click enroll, but wait, you can't actually enroll because it's not your valid appointment period for first years, that is August 8th at 6 a.m. Now, if you have a little blue box, that means the class is full, and if you have a yellow triangle, it means that you are on the waitlist, so you will be let into the class when there is space available. So one more thing I want to show you is the swap option. So let's say you want to change times of a certain course, or if you want to drop one class and choose another, swap option saves you a lot of time. So let's say I want to drop my geography class and change it with my history class. I would choose those two and then click select. Obviously, it's not going to happen right now because it's not my enrollment period. But this saves time versus dropping one class then trying to enroll in it when you can just swap and do both at the same time. So this is how you navigate RAMSS. It's a bit complicated, but trust me, you will get it. If you have any questions, leave them as a comment. I'll be happy to answer them. And as we say at Ryerson, may the odds be ever in your favor. Good luck.